Hey guys, and welcome back to Dragon Age Inquisition. What's going on here? Why is Vasti only level 6? That's weird. What's going on here is I wanted to check out the other fork of the story here. You'll remember I sided with the mages earlier, and this is gonna be the first non-canon episode of our series where I'm gonna go figure out what happens if you side with the Templars. Because obviously there's forking paths in this game, and since a lot of you guys are playing this game on your own, so I would like it if you guys tell me in the comments whenever significant quantities of content are locked away because of a decision I make, because I think I'm gonna have a second parallel character like this guy, and he's gonna make the alternate decisions when applicable to make, you know, have us play different levels so we get to see everything. So this won't be the main story. This will be sort of an alternate universe take. To be clear, what I mean by what I mean by content, I don't mean like, wow, that conversation plays out totally differently. I mean like, if you make this decision, you do a completely different level, or there's a different boss fight and stuff like that. Those kind of moments are what I'm looking for, and so that's why I'm doing this, is because there's a whole different level if you side with the Templars. And so we're gonna take a look at that, and then as soon as we're done with that, we're gonna go back to our main character and continue our journey to trying to hit high enough level to close the breach. So we'll be back to that soon enough, don't worry. So here we go in Ferelden. Don't care about much of the open stuff. It's all about making the decision. Last time we did Hushed Whispers, and this time it's time to do Champions of the Just. So, everyone's talking in the background. Note, choosing the Templars will make it impossible to work with the mages. Liliana and Josephine have been working tirelessly to convince Coerce and win over some of Orlais' most influential houses. 10 noble families will help with the Inquisition. Will help the Inquisition pressure the Templars into sealing the breach. Traveling to Terranfall Redoubt and demanding the Lord Seeker deal with them or face the wrath of Orlais. The Inquisition has promised the Herald of Andraste its voice in these negotiations. So we're going to try to deal with the Templars now because we've had such bad luck. You know, I don't know where that sentence was going, to be honest. I lost that sentence.
But the Templars must help us close the breach. The Order was founded to fight magic.
We must first convince the Lord Seeker to bring the Templars out of exile.
We've received word from a knight recruit. They gather at Therrenfall Redoubt.
It has been vacant for decades. Why go there?
We must approach the Lord Seeker again to get anywhere. We can ask him then.
The Lord Seeker made it clear he isn't interested in anyone unimportant.
So we must change how he sees us. No?
If it's status the Lord Seeker seeks, the Inquisition will approach him after allying with the noblest houses in Orlais.
They'll come with us to Therrenfall and demand the Templars' help close the breach.
You believe that will work?
Even the Lord Seeker would find it difficult to ignore so many nobles on his doorstep.
Yes. Especially when led by the Herald of Andraste.
Is it my good looks you need, or my winning smile?
Rumors you were saved from the Fade by Andraste have grown legion among the Templars.
We've done our part to encourage them.
A Herald with a few companions may be dismissed, easily set aside. That same Herald returning with noble support will be reconsidered, as will the power of the Inquisition.
Isn't there the slightest chance the Lord Seeker will see my arrival as a threat?
Before, I would have thought he was a man of reason. Now, I could not say.
With respect, after his appearance in Valroyo, hang what the Lord Seeker thinks.
We do not need the Lord Seeker. We need his Templars, with or without his approval. The breach will not wait for our differences to settle.
Good news. Several noble Orlesian houses will petition the Templars to help us stop the breach. Lord Abernash will approach you, sign nothing he offers, but his gossip's reliable.
I hope he knows the Lord Seeker's mood. The Templars will never help without his consent.
So the Lord Seeker kind of seems like this storyline's equivalent to Alexius, because Alexius was the big obstacle we had with trying to deal with the mages properly. And Lord Seeker is the guy that's running the Templars, and he's generally being a pain in the ass himself. Nope, that's the same dialogue we've already read. Okay, let's start this mission. Let's get it going. Hopefully I'll do better than I did in this mage one where I actually had a lot of trouble. Gonna take a different party with this one. I'm gonna bring Blackwall, our tank that I think, I don't know, Blackwall seems to do a little better at that tanking than Cassandra. Probably because I just spec'd him differently altogether. Interesting. We don't have Dorian at all in this party, as far as I can tell. Looks like we get to just pick a full group from scratch. So I want Solas because he's our defensive character. But I could really go with anyone for a spellcaster if I want, as far as offensive spellcasters go. Or I could even go for a rogue. It might even be fun to bring Varric along. Although Vivienne... Huh. It might be good to bring Vivienne along because I have never brought her on a story mission so far, but she does have influence, and so bringing her to deal with Orlesian diplomats or with the Templars might actually be handy. Also, it could be fun just to have her spells around. I might respec her a little. I bought a couple of respec amulets. I might use it to give her barrier since that seemed to help more recently, so it would be handy to give her that too.
The Herald of Andraste, Lord Esmerel Abernash, honored to participate. It is not unlike the second dispersal of the reclaimed Dales. Ah, Lady Vivienne, we met at last summer's ball. The Duke introduced us.
Indeed. I could not possibly forget the occasion.
The Lord Seeker is willing to hear our petition about closing the breach. A credit to our alliance with the Inquisition. Care to mark the moment? 10 Orlesian houses walk with you.
Yes. Never before has anyone purchased such an inspiring veneer of kinship. It's a grand day for genuine partnership and/or conditional servitude.
Yes, yes, but I expect the Inquisition will still take the assistance. Speaking of which, I don't suppose you'd divulge what finally got their attention. Rumor will, if you won't.
What do you mean?
The Lord Seeker won't meet us until he greets the Inquisition in person. Quite a surprise after the spat in Val Royale.
The Inquisition got the attention of many nobles. The Lord Seeker probably wants to know how.
That may be so. I tried getting an audience by offering the man a duchy. A meeting is a meeting. Get his ear. See if you can't bend it to do something advantageous. Here we are. Verinfall Redoubt.
Charming.
It appears they've sent someone to greet you. Present well. Everyone is a little tense for my liking.
The Inquisition's reach is increasing. Impressive.
The Lord Seeker changed his mind about us rather quickly. Is he known for that?
The Lord Seeker isn't reputed to be fickle. Something must have changed.
Hey, I finally heard the word said out loud. Duchi, apparently. With a vaguely Italian-sounding word in that way. Just the way that it's pronounced, I mean, with the chi part. So I'm kind of happy with this group of people for this purposes, because we're trying to make ourselves seem important and worth helping. So I brought our little magic expert that'll hopefully be helpful about information regarding the breach. I brought Vivienne, who is important to general Orlesian politics. And I brought Blackwall, who's a straight-up Grey Warden, which I feel like should have some sway. At least these seem like better characters to bring along than, say, Sarah and Varric, who no one has a lot of reason to know exist, and so they won't really hold much sway outside of their usefulness in combat, should that arise.
Have you looked at the sky, Sir Knight?
Of course, but...
Is your order not sworn to destroy heretical magic?
Yes, but...
Then if the Templars won't seal this breach, action against you shall be required.
Action against us.
The Empress of Orlais, my dear woman, listens to her thoughts.
A maker.
Well, they have a fun problem to deal with, don't they? They got a point, though. Their whole point is to deal with magic, and they're not cooperating with the one group of people that seems to have the ability to do anything about the problem.
Excuse me,
Countess. Mom. Is it true the Herald of Andraste is here? Is he among your number?
I am. And I greet you on behalf of the Inquisition.
Forgive me. I didn't realize it was you. I didn't think you'd be so, tall.
You mean Qunari?
If Andraste has chosen you as her herald, I am sure she made no mistake.
Hey, that's nice. Well, at the very least, someone's being polite at the very least. That doesn't usually happen. Oh, we have a note. Folded letter. Lord Broderick, I am delighted you've joined our cause. Last we met, we parted with such angry words that they still pain my heart. The Templars in Theronfall show the danger of letting outrage trump sense. Imagine the atrocities committed by apostates while they dally here. The Chantry has lost control, my friend. We must be the voice of calling these errant knights to reason. If it pleases you, let us meet. I would apologize and put our disagreement to rest. Humbly yours, Lord Larcher. It's like a mixture between the word LARPer and Archer, almost. That's obviously our contact. Just want to take a quick look around for anything cool lurking around the corner. Maybe not. Kind of just seemed like a place something would go.
I present Knight Templar, Sir Delrin Baris, second son of Ban Jevrin Baris of Ferelden. Sir Baris, may I be so honored as to present Lord Esmeral Abanage?
I'm the one who sent word to Cullen. He said the Inquisition works to close this breach in the veil. I didn't think you'd bring such lofty company.
Baris, moderate holdings, your family. And the second son?
This promise of status has garnered interest from the Lord Seeker. Beyond sense. The sky burns with magic, but he ignores all calls to action until your friends arrive.
The Lord Seeker does realize that's a rip into the Fade hanging above our heads.
The commanders say he's considering the situation. Maker knows how. The Lord Seeker's actions make no sense. He promised to restore the Order's honor, then marched us here to wait. Templars should know their duty, even when held from it.
A Templar who remembers his responsibilities? I am reassured.
Win over the Lord Seeker, and every able-bodied knight will help the Inquisition seal the breach.
If you think we're right, abandon the Lord Seeker and help us.
We can't abandon our orders. Not while the officers who survived the conclave follow him. We've been asked to accept much after that shameful display in Valroyo. Our truth changes on the hour.
Don't keep your betters waiting, Baris. There's important work for those born to it.
I'm getting increasingly sick of everyone who wears a mask from Alesia.
The Lord Seeker has a request before you meet him. These are the standards. An honored rite centered on the people, the Maker, and the Order. The Lord Seeker asks that you perform the rite so he may see the order in which you honor them.
What if I fail?
Well, there's no correct answer. The ritual simply shows watchers who you are and what you value.
We'd be honored, if that's what the Lord Seeker asks of the Inquisition.
Not the Inquisition. The Lord Seeker changed everything to meet you. Not the Inquisition, you. By name.
Why?
I don't know. He's been fixated on you ever since your horde of nobles arrived.
The Lord Seeker makes us shuffle flags around. Refuse! Let's meet the man already.
We'll complete the ritual as the Lord Seeker requests.
When you've completed the rite, I'll take you to him. Once you finish the standards, the Lord Seeker will see you, Herald.
Hang your own draperies, knight. We've business to conduct. What does the Lord Seeker want to see, Templar?
The Herald's choice, Abanash, not yours.
He's welcome to it.
Alrighty, so we have to choose what order in which we like these three things. So the choices are Andraste, the people, and the Templars. There's no right answer here, is there? These are all things to prioritize. Why would I raise the why would I prioritize the Templars? The Templars should be if they're servants of the people and they're supposed to be saving people from magic and they're servants of Andraste, I think Templars should be on the bottom. They are supposed to be below everything, right? Question is, do you put Andraste or the people first? Frankly, my character's Qunari and doesn't even believe in Andraste, so question is, do I do what I believe, or do I do what what would be a pandering thing to say? I'm gonna say people, Andraste, Templar, I think. There we go. Raise Andraste. And do I also pick the Templar next? Interesting strategy. Well, that didn't work how I thought it was. I guess you just stop after two. There we go. So it's gonna be the people, Andraste, Templar. And if you don't like it, you can shove it. I'm here to save the world, you motherfuckers.
Traditionally, a participant in the rite now explains their choices to those assembled.
I picked at random is actually an option. That's amazing. I let faith guide me. I decided based on politics. My reasons on my own, like being private about it, isn't really what I intend to do, but I let faith guide me and I decide based on politics are also both not what I want to pick. Where's the option that says I value the survival of people in general over any religion or order and stuff? That's not really an option here, which is kind of a bummer. So I'm going to go with my reasons are my own because I'm not happy with either of these options on top, and the bottom right one's hilarious.
Those are my choices. The rest is my own affair.
It's rather not. I'll not be shut out of any explanation these clods understand, if we're bringing them to heel.
I suppose those are your intentions.
My intent is to deal with people who matter. You helmed louts are wasting the Inquisition's time, and my time. Unacceptable!
The Lord Seeker awaits you both. Follow me.
Alright, I'm sick of this guy already. Can I make him go away? I don't like the French dude. I mean, Orlesian. Hello, Templar. Just gonna quietly go around. Ooh, I see loot. Although it's probably pointless to loot too many things unless it's gonna be immediately useful, because this might not be a continued save file. I might just use it for these videos real quick. But maybe something useful will be in there. You never know. You never know. Or do you? What the fuck am I talking about?
It's necessary, you know. You don't run a battlefield by committee.
Without faith, you've no knights. You've... Knight Captain.
You were expecting the Lord Seeker. He sent me to die for you.
Knight Captain. Lord Esmerel Abernash. Honored. It is not unlike the second dispersal of the reclaimed Dales. No doubt rank puts you above such things. A pity more people don't understand that.
This is the Grand Alliance the Inquisition offers. Sir Barris, I'm right in assuming the Knight Captain has seen better days. You, be ready.
Yes, be ready to be left behind, Knight Captain Denham.
The Lord Seeker had a plan, but the Herald ruined it by arriving with purpose. It sowed too much dissent.
Knight Captain, I must know what's going on.
You are all supposed to be changed. Now we must purge the questioning knights.
Oh shit, is there like a red wedding happening over here? Holy shit, it's a straight up betrayal.
For once, I agree with the...
Thank God.
The Elder One is coming. No one will leave Ferenfar who is not stained in red.
Make us breath.
Well, this is a problem. It looks like immediately we have the Elder One fucking up this place too. So at least we have one friend, Knight Commander Barris. Hopefully I can keep him alive throughout this encounter, because he'll probably continue to help me. There's Knight Captain Denham, the guy causing all this. How many people are over here?
Red Templar marksman, regular. So one, we have two ranged, one melee. One melee over here. Who's back here? That's my whole party. Is that everyone we have to deal with? So we have to deal with 1, 2, 3. We have to deal with 5 units. 3 of which are melee, 2 of which are ranged, 1 of which is probably a boss. Oh no, he's not even elite. He just has higher defense. Oh yeah, he's level 6. Is everyone else level 5? Sorry, I'm trying to get an idea of what's about to happen to me. Okay, so, to get an idea what's going on here, I respect Vivienne to give her useful spells. She has Dispel and Barrier, and Solas, of course, has Dispel and Barrier. He's my defensive caster. That's basically all he does. But Vivienne, on top of her electric powers, also has some defensive spells now to keep my party going better. And Blackwall is still here to be my awesome tank. I'm gonna say let's focus fire on their goddamn boss and just see how that works for us. Because it seems like the way to go. Make a mess! Alright. Oh! That hurt. There we go. Their boss... Yeah, Denim's gonna go down pretty quickly here. Ow! Dick. Okay, can someone bubble me? Vivienne already bubbled. Okay. Oh, no. That is the problem. Like, it seems like a good idea to give everyone the barrier ability, but unfortunately... They're really bad about casting it at the same time. You know what? I'm just gonna commit. Let's see. Let's go into tactics. I'm just gonna disable barrier. There we go. I'm gonna make her just focus on offensive spells, and barrier and dispel will be disabled until I deem them usable. So, and meanwhile, Solas will just use those spells whenever he feels like. It's become too much of a problem for whenever you give a second mage barrier, they just cast it at the same time, which is the dumbest possible thing to do in that situation, but the game doesn't give you a lot of options for preventing it, unfortunately. Let's just make a mess! Alright, Denim's about to go down. Unfortunately, it went through a little bit of a healing potion. Oh, Denim's unkillable, apparently. He enters that... That's right, counterattack, motherfucker. Oh, that wasn't a counterattack, that was my chain ability. I pressed the wrong button. It's slightly non-intuitive. Oh, come on. Counterattack, there we go. It is actually fun to play a melee character in real time. I should probably do this more often, because I can time his counterattacks properly. It's not actually called, it's called something else, but it's basically a counterattack. I think most melee characters have some version of a counter ability.
Is the Knight Captain alive?
Barely. If you use a healing elixir, he may survive, if he even deserves it.
We'll heal him. Let's judge the Knight Captain after we find his master.
I agree. We've no idea what came over him.
He hardly deserves our charity.
The Knight Captain's keys. I would question the Lord Seeker about this Elder One.
So judging from what we know about the Elder One, and what he did in our previous area when we went to the Mage Zone, he's probably some kind of demon at this point. Everything that we're seeing right now... I can't open this chest? Ah. Everything we're seeing right now kind of suggests what we saw a lot, and I mean like in every level of Dragon Age Inquisition. Wow, I'm down 4 potions already. I probably have to disable potions, don't I? Because everyone's just going to blow through all my potions when I don't want them to. Yeah, okay, let's go through and disable potions for everybody, because these guys are going to... Oops. I always get a little bit screwed up by this. So potion healing reserve is all. There we go. Because we have a resurrection spell for the purpose of not having to spam our potions. It's unfortunate how fast people go through them. So we'll probably find a cache soon, so it won't be such a big deal. All right, so who do we have in here? One level 6 Templar. A second level 6 Templar. We'll just focus fire on this guy first, because he's at least in plain sight. Knock him on his ass. There we go. Yep, there's a little block encounter. I probably should just be playing this game in real time more often to some extent. There we go. Wow, the counter really works too. There we go. Is that everybody? Because as a general rule, the spellcasters are actually relatively good at managing themselves. It's just the melee characters that are so goddamn awful. But if I just let the casters run themselves, they probably won't do too terrible of a job. We have 2 staircases here. Oops, pressed the wrong button. Oh, there's multiple floors again. 3 floors this time. So this is the base floor that we were already on. Oh, no, that's where we're trying to go. Okay, we're currently here. There we are, okay. That's a lot of noise. I guess I'll just pick a direction and commit to it. What could go wrong, right? Do I have, I don't have any regeneration potions on me, just like before. Right, I'm just as unprepared as I was last time. What's this? Requires a rogue. No, it doesn't. Ha ha ha. I learned that trick from the subreddit. Apparently, if it doesn't say like deft hands and fine tools, you can just beat down anything you find. Did I not loot this properly? Oh, it's a second loot thing. Ooh. That's multiple schematics. That'd be handy if this wasn't probably a temporary character just for this quest. What are we gonna find around here? Keep an eye out for items, just because who knows what we'll find that could be useful.
Prepare them! Guide them to me!
There are bad guys behind
this
wall.
Was that the Lord Zika?
I heard nothing.
That must have been broadcasted to everyone in general. So what do we have down here? Red Templar? What's that? Is just another Red Templar? Red Templar level 7? Does he look better too? I know they all have the crazy helmets. Level 7 is... Okay, and down here we have... I guess it's just a marksman, probably also level 7. If you look at these guys... Oh, they're covered in red. Look at that. Wait, are there two Templars standing here? Why is there a double of everything on his face? Is that intentional, or is that... That's fucking weird, right? Maybe there's two Red Templars that are standing inside of each other here. I can't tell. That's fucking weird. Everything on his face is doubled. Is that happening to this guy too? I can't look close enough to find out, can I? Anyway, looks like our goal is somewhere over here. Is there a door? Nope. So I must have to go upstairs. So I probably have to go... Oh god, there's more... I did not see those guys up there. That would have been a bad surprise. So there's three guys up there. And... That door probably takes me closer to my goal. I really wish there was a proper isometric camera for this view, because it's very easy to miss details because you have to walk around in weird angles. You're either way up high and looking straight down, but also not having a proper field of view for how, like, you can't go far enough away. And then you can be down to the floor where you're at straight up, like, horizontal to the ground camera angle, which is not always super useful. This might be tough. I'm going to say go ahead and chug a potion, Vasti, before we start this, because otherwise you're probably going to go down before I want you to. All right, let's get ready to make a mess. Actually, let's open with a Solus casting bubble while we're all in a group still. There we go. All right, let's make a mess. I guess we'll just hop in and get into fighting, because we can't really... How do I get up there to even fight those guys? Do I just have to hit them with ranged attacks? Oh, there's a ladder. Okay. We'll have to make that ladder. Our ranged characters could probably make some form of mess, though. Let's see. Maybe I can do something with Vivienne. Can I get up there? How do I get the camera up there? Can I follow the ladder? Oh, there we go. I can probably cast lightning bolts to AoE these guys and cause some problems for them. There we go. That'll probably help. I hope. Let's go make a mess! Hey, asshole. Get over here. That was a super late chain attack. I don't know why. I need to get in the swing of things, obviously. Oh, this character does have whirlwind. That could be handy. Get away from my guys! Alright, you guys are grouped up, so we'll do a taunt for the bonus armor. And then a whirlwind to cause some real damage. Vivienne is down already. Try to keep this going, though. Solus should self-bubble. I think he has that skill. So he'll be alive for a little while. Oh, Vasky's down. Gonna have to control Blackwell for a second here to get him back up.
Show me what you are.
Okay, so really quick here. Definitely... Oh! Crap. I meant to open the tactical menu, but I failed. Oh, well. We'll bubble the people who are still alive. And I can use Vasti. Where's Vasti? Who's that over there? Oh, that's Solus. Solus is about to go down, isn't he? That's a problem. Okay, I'll use Vasti to get our Blackwell back up, though, in a second here. Did Vivienne just completely disregard my order to cast Bubble? Because I don't see a barrier on anybody right now. Was she out of mana? What the fuck? Get them bubbled up over there. There we go. Just keep it going, grab Solus. Oh, am I dying? I'm not dead yet. Okay. Static cage. Create a mess over there. That wasn't static cage, was it? That was chain lightning. Okay. We're doing okay. People are going down, but I don't want to use up all of my potions so quickly. I'm going to focus on just helping people from here. Who's over there? Is that Vasti? Where is that Vasti? I can't fucking see anything from this point of view. It's weird that... There we go. Let's go. We'll go tactical mode. There we go. This is such a better camera for stuff. Oh, Vasti's down altogether. Okay. Well, we'll bubble real quick to at least get these two people... Oh, did he get... I got him. Okay. And then get Vasti back up. It's all about those self-revives, right? Alright, let's got some problems. Fuck you! Who's left? Did we win yet? Oh, there's one guy with the shield hanging out over there. Oh, fuck, there's an ambush. Guys, get over here. Guys, let's hang out over here for a moment. If they're gonna charge us, let's at least be in a group. Wow, things do kind of just work out better in real time, don't they? That's kind of shocking. Though it would be nice to recover health over time in some capacity. Let's see. Oop, loot. There we go. I will never claim to be good at this game. I'm just scraping by and figuring things out. So, are they going to come pouring out of that door? Take a quick look. So there's one marksman in the doorway. Two Templars out here. Oh, they've both been hurt. These are red Templars. They're probably fighting that normal Templar, and he probably went down. That's a bummer. I might have been able to save him. So that's why they're low on health, though. Is there anyone upstairs? There's a chest. Wow, I can really just keep going for a while, can't I? So that general direction must be my goal, and there's two silhouettes of blue people up there, so those are people I could potentially help, I think, and maybe we'll have more friends on our side. Yeah, that's an adorable pose. Let's go create a mess. Alright, are you guys ready? Let's switch to Vasti, and just tell everyone to target this marksman, and take him down as fast as possible. I'll try to keep an eye on our bubbles, and hopefully as soon as possible... Pull him over here! Yes! You're fucked, dude. Hopefully, as soon as our things go down, I'll get a chance to use bubble via VVN. There we go. Okay, so switch to VVN and bubble again, because everyone's down on their bubbles. Can she even reach there? There we go. They're bubbled again, so they'll last a little longer, despite having no freaking defensive capabilities. And they're both using Warcry. Good job, AI, queuing up Warcry to give them guard, which will give them much more longevity. Let's see. Oh, shit. There we go. I missed my chance to guard for a second there because it's not always easy to guard in time. There's a lot of chaos happening on screen, but hey, we got through that without any deaths, despite everyone having no hit points left. There we go. Maybe this will lead to a difference in my playstyle, just playing in first person as Vasti while manually managing barriers along the way. Maybe the way to go. It's hard to say what to do in this game. Everyone's trying to figure out how to handle the AI, because the AI is really weird and disregards what you want it to do sometimes. And so everyone's like, use tactical camera more, use tactical camera less. Don't use tactical camera, it's useless. It's the only way you can beat nightmares to use tactical all the time. People are not sure how to play this game at this point, and I'm not going to argue with any of them. I'm still figuring it out myself. To be corrupted. The corruption is taking hold now. What doesn't hurt is numb. Head's all foggy, but the scientist in me can't help but describe what this feels like. My body is breaking down. The fingernails were the first to go. I started to itch all over, and when I scratched, they peeled back. Clumps of hair fell away, then clumps of flesh. I hear a song in my head. It's deafening. The most beautiful thing I've ever heard, but I don't hear it with my ears. It's in my brain. A blissful sound. This must be the call for which the darkspawn yearn, that causes them to dig so feverishly. I'd still rather die. Suppose that's something. Missive found in the deep road, signed only, Warden Pierce. Aww. So it's someone dealing with a darkspawn infection, which is a little weird to find here, because... I don't think this is related to the Darkspawn right now. I think this has to do with a demon, is what I'm figuring. Do a quick look around for any loot I can find. Did someone drop anything up here? Nope. Just climb back down. Ooh! No discernible fall damage. I gotta do a sweep around the area, because there could... Ooh, there's a ladder that goes up there. That might be where I go next. I want to take a look around for a potion stash, if there's one. This bag is just standing up on its own. They usually lean those against something. Hello. There we go. More loot. I'm finding more and more things I could craft potions out of. It would be handy if I could find a place to actually craft them, though. Because otherwise, they're not super useful for me until after this instance. I mean, dungeon, or whatever. I don't see a potion stand anywhere, unfortunately. Ooh, what's this? What's this? What's this? They've had me go on for a while without a stash, aren't they? So this is where I was able to go a second ago. Is a body of a... Is a dead mage, I think? Are the Templars with the weird thing on their chest a mage? Okay, so I can go up there next. That's where I saw the blue figure. That I can't take the cursor up there to figure out what it is, though. Oh, well. So we're just going to go back inside and go upstairs now. It seems like the way to go. I figured it was. It's just I wanted to take a look around for anything useful in the environment. Like a stash of potions, for example. We'll find out what that chest upstairs wants, hasn't it? Intense Death Root Vintar. That's a useful item for a Qunari character, since we can't use helms, although it might be the same one I'm already having. Unfortunately, I find every time that I get another helm, it's the same helm. Okay, so we have two Templar Knights. They're already going down. At least they're equal. They all have 2,000 hit points. I thought they might be unfair about it, but they're relatively fair. There's a marksman, and over here we have... I assume it's just an identical marksman. I can't bring my cursor to him, unfortunately. So let's definitely just get in there and create a problem as fast as possible. So you're already casting barrier, right? On our group. Definitely get the... definitely go for our tanks first. And you should probably cast Static Cage to create a problem around the combat zone for the enemies. That's probably a good starting point. Okay, let's go make a mess. Shout! Shouting's definitely really handy for generating guard at the beginning of a fight whenever there's more than one enemy. And generally, that's when you need guard the most, is when there's actually multiple targets. There we go, they're down. Oh god, where'd these extra enemies come from? I didn't see them. Shit, this could be bad for me. Come on, go down. I can't use my knockdown yet. There we go. Knockdown is active. Keep wailing on him. Blackwall just went down. Counterattack. Was that a successful counter? There we go. That's a proper counterattack. Come on. Keep things going. Okay, so definitely need you to use... Have you already used revival? Who'd you revive with revival? I don't see anyone alive right now. Weird. Seems like he already used it. So he doesn't really have any abilities that I can use right now. I'd like to at least get Vivienne up. Please don't die in this brief second where I'm not controlling you. Okay, my tank... Vasti was smart enough to use his guard generator. Where did Blackwall go down? I don't see him. Oh, Vasti's down. Okay. Let's create a... I can't bury either of these characters. Okay, so... Solas is about to bury... Yeah, he's about to barrier us already, so... And I can't revive anyone for a while. I could just create a static cage to cause problems. Nope, he's not gonna move, so I should just Thunderbolt him. Lightning Bolt, motherfucker! Clunk! Don't have mana for anything else right now, just need to regenerate for a moment. Did we win? No, we haven't won yet. There's a guy over here. He's also about to go down, though, we're fine. Just finish him off. We scraped by, but we win. Okay. And I'm saving a lot of healing potions by not bringing everybody up at every opportunity. Everyone's up. All right, we're good. All right, and we still have all three of our healing potions. We used none of them. Things seem to be going okay. And it's weird. I guess you can just sort of get away with automating combat more than I have been so far, because things seem to be mostly handling themselves if I just control Vasti and go for it, which is weird because... It feels like everything's falling apart the moment it feels like everything's always falling apart when I'm playing in tactical view. This game's really counterintuitive in some ways, where some stuff doesn't seem to work properly.
The Herald of Andraste, it's time we became better acquainted.
Well, he's gonna be great to deal with. He's clearly a demon, right? He's even doing crazy voice
what
stuff
now. What do you
think
to accomplish? What will you become?
I'm gonna punch you in the dick, how about that? Does that sound like fun times for you? This is a very dramatic walkway. Is he gonna just be right in that room? Is this... Because if so, this is a way shorter dungeon than the mage's area was. Might even be just one episode for all I know, where the other one took three. Also, without the crazy scene of like Leliana being tortured and stuff like that, so... Weird. It'd be interesting to see two storylines where one of them is just noticeably more detailed and interesting than the other one. But no matter what happens, you definitely meet the old one, and the old one is causing very disturbing problems. Seems to have direct connections with Red Lyrium in particular, because whenever the old one shows up, people have Red Lyrium issues. What am I going to find? Oh,